I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere. That's the only song that ever drove me to using cue cards for the lyrics. We had to sing about 50 tongue-twisting names of cities, very fast, smiling, and doing the two-step at the same time. Hi, I'm Sandy Griffith, and in case you haven't guessed it, the theme of this Lawrence Welk show is the world. How's that for a big subject? I'm sure they chose me for this show because they know these days I love to travel. Coincidentally, the song right after the opening number is Waltzing Mathilda, and my husband Brent and I have just returned from a trip to Australia and New Zealand. We snorkeled along the Great Barrier Reef, we rode a 100-year-old train and then army ducks into the rainforest, and had a gorgeous meal out there with entertainment by the Aborigines, dancing and playing the didgeridoo. What a wonderful day that was. Later on down in Sydney, we visited a sheep farm and watched their amazingly fast shearing process. Then we went to a koala bear park where we were surrounded by those adorable creatures, and we enjoyed being in a petting area of kangaroos where you could touch and feed them. We came away from our trip with the thought we always have. It really is a big, wide world, and we love seeing it. Now it's time to sing our way around the world, and here's our travel guide, Mr. Lawrence Welk.
From Hollywood, the Lawrence Welk Network presents The Lawrence Welk Show.
And welcome aboard as our musical family takes you for a musical trip around this big, wide, wonderful world. No bags to pack, no reservations to make. Just sit back, folks, relax, and enjoy the music. Clay Hart usually sings country songs of America, but I think you'll agree he also does a wonderful job with this song from Australia.
Once a jolly swagman sat beside a billabong under the shade of the coolibah tree, and he sang as he watched, waited while his billy boiled. You'll come a waltzing Mathilda with me, waltzing Mathilda, waltzing Mathilda. You'll come a waltzing Mathilda with me, and he sang as he watched and waited while his billy boiled. You'll come a waltzing Mathilda with me. Down came a jumbuck, drink by the billabong. Up jumped the swag man and grabbed him with glee. And he sang as he stowed that jumbuck in his tucker bag. You'll come a waltzing Mathilda with me. Waltzing Mathilda, waltzing Mathilda. You'll come a waltzing Mathilda with me. And he sang as he stowed that jumbuck in his tucker bag. You'll come a waltzing Mathilda with me. Waltzing Mathilda, waltzing Mathilda. You'll come a waltzing Mathilda with me. And he sang as he stowed that jumbuck in his tucker bag. You'll come a waltzing Mathilda with me. You'll come a waltzing Mathilda with me.
You! Well, thank you, Neil, Buddy, John, Dick Loop on bass. Next, the band gives us something with a little French flavor. And you'll hear my good friend, again, Neil Levang, on the acoustic guitar, the song Poor People of Paris. Take it away, Neil.
Wasn't it good to hear that melody again? I guess every tourist comes up against the language barrier once in a while. Let's see how Sandi and Salli are getting along in Paris.
Excuse me, sir. Could you tell
Salli, no English.
What are we going to do? We don't speak French.
Try this.
Maybe this will help. French book?
Yes.
Okay. The book, le livre, the book, the pen, la plume, the pen,
la chaise,
le crayon,
le cahier,
le papier, noir, rouge et blanc, are black, red and white. Rouge, blanc et noir? Hey, you're really bright. Now let's go back.
I bet we get them right.
Rouge, blanc et noir, la papier, la cahier, la crayon, la chaise, la plume, le livre, et rouge, la chaise, et noir. That's marvelous, Sandi.
You call this work, it's more like play.
In no time, flash je parle français.
My turn?
Your turn.
Are you ready?
Yes. The door, la porte, the door of wood. Du bois of wood, to open, ouvrir. Ouvrir, to open. To shut, ferme. Ferme, to shut. The pronouns we need are je and vous.
Je means me and vous means you.
Now, do them all.
Just watch us plow right through. Je and vous, to shut, ferme, to open, ouvrir, la porte, du bois, rouge, blanc et noir, la papier, la cahier, la crayon, la chaise, la plume, la livre.
J'ouvre la porte, je ferme la porte. That's marvelous.
You
lead off.
Okay.
You take it first.
The hand, la main, the hand, the mouth, la bouche, the mouth, les yeux sont bleus.
Hey, they really are blue.
Les cheveux,
the hair,
les cheveux. The word for boy and girl are garçon et fille, are he and she. Now from the top.
We'll get our French degree.
Garçon et fille, les cheveux, the hair, les yeux sont bleus, la bouche, la main. J'ai vu tout chat fermé, tout open, ouvrir la porte du bois, le rendez Noël, la pépé, la cahier, la crayon, la chaise, la plume, la livre.
Wow. In no time flash you pas français.
We're great. Let's go order a dinner now.
A dinner?
I'm really hungry. With... Did you see those great 1971 outfits we were wearing? Well, guess what? They're back. I've told my kids I've already worn clothes like this, and now I can prove it. The person dressed just like me is my longtime friend, Sally Flynn. We met at Brigham Young University and sang together in the college's performance group, then called the Program Bureau. We toured the Orient with the group, entertaining the GIs for the Defense Department. And both of us were totally hooked on show business by the time we got home. Sally was my first singing partner, and in 1968, we were lucky enough to be chosen by Mr. Welk to be on his show. Sally and I were always given the wordiest songs, like the French lesson you just saw. Neither one of us spoke French, so we had to practice. It was a fun way to learn a few words in another language. But when Brent and I were in Australia, we learned that English words can have entirely different meanings in other countries. The song Waltzing Mathilda, which you heard earlier, is a good example. A waltzing Mathilda is the swinging knapsack of a hobo. And the song tells the story of a man who steals a lamb, stuffs it into a sack, the owner sees him, sets chase, and the thief jumps into the water or billabong, where his ghost is heard forevermore. See? You never know what you learn on the Lawrence Welk Show.
Now to add a little Spanish atmosphere to our show, we call on Charlotte and her cello with Bob Ralston at the organ, Lady of Spain. Wasn't that nice? Very, very nice, Bob and Charlotte. And I see you. Cousin John got into the act with the castanets. Pretty Gail Farrell from Oklahoma and Dick Dale from Iowa have some travel plans of their own.
Let's take a boat to Bermuda.
Let's take a plane to St. Paul.
Let's take a kayak come back at all.
Let's take a powder to Boston for chowder.
Let's get away from it all.
We'll travel round from town to town. We'll visit every state. And I'll repeat, I love you, sweet, in all the 50 states. Let's go again to Niagara.
This time we'll look at the fall.
Let's leave our hut, dear.
Get out of our rut, dear.
Let's get away from it all.
We'll travel around from town to town. We'll visit every state.
And I'll repeat, I love you, sweet, in all the 50 states.
Well, let's go again to Niagara.
Yeah, this time we'll look at the fall.
Hey, let's leave our hut, dear.
Get out of our rut, dear.
Let's get away from it all.
Why do you want to get away from it all?
Oh, we were only kidding. We like it here.
Yeah, it's a pretty good place.
Well, good for you. Gypsy music and dancing are always exciting. And here's a sample featuring Bobby and Cissy and our singer.
Through the forest, wild and free, sounds our gypsy melody.
My married daughter, Jenny. She is the oldest of my seven children, and she and her husband, Mike, graduated from Brigham Young University this year. We belong to the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, the Mormons, and our church invites young people to go on missions all over the world. Jenny, why don't you tell us about your mission?
I had a fabulous experience in South Texas for 18 months. It was a great opportunity to teach people about the gospel of Jesus Christ. My brother, Chad, served a two-year mission in Missouri. We both met wonderful people and learned so much through traveling and teaching. Chad is going to school in Utah these days.
Amy is finishing her degree in family counseling at BYU. She's still playing the harp and is working for KBYU, the public broadcasting station in Provo, Utah. Our third missionary, Ben, is currently serving in the Northern Jungles of Guatemala. Ben will be a great missionary.
And Mom's mission these days is teaching a 6:30 a.m. seminary class of high school seniors, studying the Old Testament before they go to school each morning.
It may be early, but I'm lucky because I can teach in English. Here's a musical tribute to all of those wonderful people who cross cultural barriers of any kind.
Our happy Norwegian Myron Floren has a polka for any occasion. Myron would like to salute our neighbor country, Mexico, with the Chihuahua Polka.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, folks, and muchas gracias to my amigos, Jack, Buddy, Neil.
Bob, mighty fine, mighty fine.
Here's a man who has done his share of traveling, and like a lot of us, he loves Hawaii and its music. Ken Delo sings one of the most beautiful of all island melodies, the Hawaiian Wedding Song, Buddy Merrill on steel guitar.
Thank you, Myron. Unfortunately, I forgot to bring along the most important instrument to put everyone in the mood for this particular type of song, so I'm going to have to improvise a little bit. If you'll just use your imaginations along with me, could I have a little arpeggio there, please? This'll get to you. Thank you. Thank you. Unfortunately, it's very hard to play nose and sing at the same time, so I'm going to have to ask for a little assistance from Buddy Merrill, if you please, Buddy.
This is the moment I've waited for. I can hear my heart singing. Soon bells will be ringing. This is the moment of sweet Aloha. Promise me that you will leave me never. I will love you longer than forever. Here and now, dear, all my love I vow here. So promise me that you will leave me never. And I will love you longer than forever. Now that we are one, clouds won't hide the sun, blue skies of Hawaii smile on this our wedding day. I do love you.
Thank you, fellas.
Thank you very much. Thank you. You know, England has always been noted for being a country of pomp and ceremony and much formality. So we're going to give you our version of an English ceremony. It may not be authentic, but I think it's a lot of fun anyway.
Say, is this the place where they still parade the king's horses and the king's men?
Right there, Governor. In fact, I think I can hear them right now. The king's horses and the king's men, they march down the street and they march back again. The king's horses and our king's men. They're in scarlet and they're in gold. They're all gussied up. They're a joy to behold. The king's horses and our king's men.
They're not up to fight the foe. You might think so, but oh dear no, they're all begone, they're not to go.
To put that little temp into the Lord Mayor's show.
If they're duty now and then, to march down the street and to march back again. The king's horses and the king's men.
Don't you think?
They're not out to bite the foe.
You might think so, but oh dear no.
They're out because they've got to go.
To put a little pet into the Lord Mayor show.
They're duty down there, to march down the street and to march back again. The king's horses and the king's men. The king's horses and the king's men.
Kingsman. Here are the youngest three of my seven children, Emily, Daniel, and Samuel, who still live at our house that seems to be emptying entirely too fast. Hey guys, how about a quick game of shuffleboard?
Right.
All right. Emily is a super energetic 16-year-old high school student who earns top grades. She's in her third year of cheerleading and wins prizes for winning the 100-yard hurdles. This summer, she was a lifeguard at Hurricane Harbor, the water park attached to Six Flags Magic Mountain. Emily hopes to attend Brigham Young University. Daniel is a 14-year-old ninth grader who loves to dance, move over Bobby Burgess, and loves sports. He's also a great runner and may end up on the track team. But right now, he's playing high school football while his mother sits in the bleachers and worries.
Yes. Oh, that's nice.
Sam is 11 years old in the sixth grade and is terrific on the computer and a champ at Super Nintendo games. He's just a very good student and has been selected as one of the members of the Peace Patrol Committee, a group of kids recruited to promote the right spirit on campus and actually trained in how to defuse arguments and fights on the playground. Well, that's the update on our three youngest children. But that's not the end of the story. Our foster daughter, Debbie, just had her fourth baby, and I'm really enjoying the role of grandma. It's a good thing, too, because I'd like to have as many grandchildren as Vienna has waltzes.
Watching the boss do the Viennese waltz with Cissy, it's hard for me to realize that for over 3 years, he
He's been eligible for Social Security. Now from Vienna, it's just a short trip to the Alps. And here's a song from The Sound of Music about the pretty snow flower that grows high in those mountains. And let's listen to our favorite husband and wife team, Guy and Ralna.
Thank you, Myron. Goodbye.
Quite a few countries here on the show tonight.
We sure have, but you know, there's one country that we haven't gotten to yet, and that's Italy.
Italy? I think I know just the person that could show us around Italy, don't you?
You're right. My friend, Tanya.
Sometimes the world is a valley of heartaches and tears, and in the hustle and bustle, no sunshine appears.
My favorite paisanos, Bob Lido, Charlie Pilata, and some more of my big cumbares.
Gracias, Tanya. Selecta.
Mari, oui Mari, quando suona diverse per te, fammi dormi, una notte abbracciato con te, oui Mari, quando suona diverse per te, fammi dormi, oui Mari.
I recorded an album called Counting My Blessings, and the whole family sang on it. It's a unique mini time capsule where children's voices never change. I thought you might like to hear one of the songs and take a look at our family as we grew through the years.
Lovely champagne lady Norma Zimmer and Jimmy Roberts add a German touch to our show with the song Auf Wiedersehen.
Please.
Dudley, Norma, and Jim. Here's Arthur Duncan with his contribution to our musical tour. Arthur will be dancing to the Song of India. And by the way, before Arthur gets started, let's have a few strains by Pops Barney Liddell. Some very nice trombone work by Barney Liddell. Joe Feeney is next in our solo spot, so I'm sure you folks can guess what our next stop will be.
Have you ever heard the story of how Ireland got its name? I'll tell you so you'll understand from whence old Ireland came. No wonder that we're proud of that dear land across the sea. For here's the way my dear, dear mother told the tale to me. Sure, a little bit of heaven fell from out the sky one day and nestled on the ocean in a spot so far away. And when the angels found it, sure it looked so sweet and fair, they said suppose we'd leave it, for it looked so peaceful there. So they sprinkled it with stardust is the only place you'll find them, no matter where you go. Then they dotted it with silver to make its lake so grand. And when they had it finished, sure they
again, this time sandwiched between a beautiful Irish melody sung by Joe Feeney and a classic Scottish folk song, Loch Lomond. And it's the perfect place for me because my paternal grandmother, Emily Steele Jensen, was Scotch-Irish, had red hair, and was a singer. I named my daughter after her because she was one of the great musical influences on my life. Grandma Emily was born in 1887, and she and Grandpa Pop raised one daughter and five sons. We had lots of family gatherings, which always included music. Sometimes Grandma played her piano, a baby grand, which I inherited and I really treasure. Grandma Emily loved Lawrence Welk so much that she refused to leave home on Saturday nights. The one time she missed seeing the show was when her kids took her and Grandpa to celebrate their 46th wedding anniversary with Lawrence Welk and his orchestra playing in the San Fernando Valley. Lawrence danced with my Grandma Emily, and that was one of the highlights of my grandmother's life. She wasn't here to see me sing on the show, but I know she's really proud that I'm a member of Lawrence's musical family. Grandma would love the Scottish folk song coming up next.
Great trombone man, supported by Bob Smale on piano and our fine rhythm section. After traveling all over the world, American tourists often find there's no place like home. Our singers put it in their own words.
What's more American than squatting? I am.
What's more?
across the land.
And what's more American than saying, I am, I am, I am.
What's more American than saying, I am, I am, I am.
Lawrence Welk was an ultra-patriot and held firm to his beliefs in those anti-American protest days during the Vietnam War. Sally Flynn and I had gone to Vietnam to entertain the troops in 1967, and we knew what it was like for all those young men and women who were putting their lives in jeopardy 24 hours a day. We understood completely, and were proud of the way Mr. Welk took a positive pro-American stand when it was unpopular to do so. This is the greatest country in the world, and we are the most blessed people on the face of the earth. When Lawrence Welk said, God bless America, and he said it often, we echoed that sentiment, and I hope you do too. Thanks for watching and for supporting public television. Let's pray for peace throughout our world, and God bless us, everyone.
Peace, peace, that's right, you've got it.